It is hard sometimes not to get emotional because sometimes you have to pull yourself back and understand that a lot of these people just don't have a lot of the information that I have when I'm talking to them. So I have to remember that because sometimes, you know, when you start to, you know, when you really start to dive into a subject matter and you start to ascertain all this information and all this knowledge, and then when you start talking to other people, and you're just like, God, you're a fucking idiot. but in reality, it's just you've amassed so much information that things that are kind of nuanced to certain people, they're just a given to you because you've been studying and paying attention to this issue for so long. And so I have to keep reminding myself of that when I talk to certain people with respect to this issue. And also understand what I've learned to do over the time is try to figure out where the motivations are coming from. Mm. Once you can kind of understand somebody's motivation for why they feel a certain way, you can talk to them on that level and you can break down those barriers a lot quicker.
Yeah, but that only happens when you can actually have a back and forth conversation with somebody without the risk of losing everything if you say the wrong thing in that conversation. We've created this. I've got another show called American Party with Dakota Meyer. We were just talking about it this morning about how there's no tolerance for somebody being wrong at some point and then getting the right information and then moving into the category of right, which is, by the way, how everybody on Earth forever has learned anything.
Yes.
That's fucking how it works. I'm ignorant. I don't know what's happening. Then I learned math. Now I know math.
Yeah.
But somehow we can't apply that to being wrong on an issue. It's the equivalent is if with the fucking cancel culture, particularly on Twitter, is if you change the rules to football and then went back retroactively and applied those rules to the games that happened 15 fucking years ago. That's stupid.
Yeah.
Only a psycho would even think of doing something like that. Right. And it lets you know that it's not about justice. It's about they're being punitive. Mm-hmm. They're upset about whatever it is. And they're trying to lash out at people. That's not how you govern a country. It can't be, because this is the result.
Yeah, not only is this the result, but again, it's admitting when you're wrong and right about certain issues. I mean, shit, I got in a fight with my wife the other day. It was my fault. I came back, you know, an hour later and I said, hey, what I said was stupid and I was wrong and we moved on with our lives. But that's the only way we could move on with our lives if I said, hey, I'm wrong about this and I made a mistake and I apologize. Why aren't others more receptive to that, Colin?
I think a lot of it is we've turned, I want to say we, I want to place it on the media because it's so much easier to do that. But I do think they have a big hand in this is we've turned dialogue and debate into a combative engagement. Like it's almost like a sport now. So the goal isn't, which changes the goal, right? The goal then becomes winning versus to trying to discover or figure out solutions or enlightenment. And so when the overall goal becomes winning, there's no way in hell you're going to get me to sit up here and say, well, you know what? I actually don't know anything about that, or I'm wrong. Because then essentially what that means is I've admitted defeat. And for me, I've gotten caught up in that my damn self, to be honest. Like if you look at the very genesis of what I used to do, if you look at some of the platforms that I've gone on, or even on my show Noir, when I was having conversations with people and talking to them about it, I saw myself slipping into the more combative in terms of trying to win the conversation versus having the conversation. But I will say there's a certain insecurity when you're a public figure like myself, and you know, people look up to you to be their voice. There is that insecurity where you're like, can I admit that I don't really know this much about this particular aspect of the issue without letting the people who look up to me down?
Right.
And I'm to be honest with you, I don't know that's a balancing act that I honestly have not perfected. I don't really know where it lives or where it doesn't. So I kind of walk around on a daily basis with that insecurity. And so I find myself trying to constantly just amass and get as much information as I possibly can in order to never find myself in that position. But I don't really know how realistic that is.